sponsors.
مولاي صلي وسلم دائما
praise the messenger
محمد يا حبيبي يا حبيبي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما على محمد يا حبيبي يا حبيبي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما
This is Abdul Malik from Native Deen and Deen TV. I'm here with none other than Khalid Siddiq.
Assalamu alaikum, alhamdulillah. Pleasure to be here, alhamdulillah.
All the way from the UK,
yeah, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah, here at the RIS.
Yes, yeah,
alhamdulillah. Great performance,
Thank you so much, beautiful. Thank you.
I love the message that you said, you know, we need to do the salawat.
The salawat.
Allah shares no act of ibadah with us, except praising the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The malaika holding their weapons are sending their praise upon the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is something that should not be on the back burner of our minds.
I don't hear it speaking about enough, so I thought, you know what, if I can leave with any message, just to keep that in people's minds, the importance of salawat, you know, it's not something to just be put on the side, it's something we should hold on to, you know.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit about yourself as an artist, like, when did you start? I mean, you've been doing this for a bit now.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. Well, I mean, I've been doing music ever since I was like 8, 9, and my father's a musician as well.
Yeah.
So I was always around music growing up, and I was just doing what I would say, you know, conventional music up until the age of maybe like 21, something like that, and then I kind of made a change. I thought, you know what, Allah's blessed me with this gift, and I started becoming more conscious, started to gain more like awareness of things that I was doing, things that I was saying, and the music that I was creating. So I thought, you know what, let me use this gift. A lot of people around me were telling me, use this gift that you have, not to, you know, sin. Is that you want to do it something that's going to, you know, praise Allah, call people towards good. So it was a hard shift, you know, as we know, the human being is very arrogant and whatever. Yes. But eventually, you know, I made the shift, and alhamdulillah, you know, things have been going very well since.
Alhamdulillah. So a lot of your songs that I've heard have almost a Caribbean vibe.
Yes, yeah, alhamdulillah.
And
yeah.
Myself, my parents, my father's from Cuba, and my mom's from Aruba.
Nice,
alhamdulillah. My grandparents are from Trinidad.
MashaAllah.
So do you have
so I'm half Jamaican, half Irish.
So you got some.
My father's from Jamaica, Kingston.
Okay.
My mother's from Ireland, yeah, alhamdulillah. Southern Ireland, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, all right. So I love that aspect that you bring out in music.
I think that's what's great about Islam is, you know, it's not just about everyone having to look a certain way or fit into a certain, you know, box. And that's the only way, you know, you can bring your own flavor to it. You know, if I hear an Indonesian artist, I want to see your style of, you know, your culture and how you're going to fuse that into Islam, rather than you trying to be something else. So I think that's I think that's what lends the strength to Islam is its, you know, diversity and its flexibility in different cultures and different ways of expressing, alhamdulillah.
That's beautiful. I mean, you've done music, songs, you know, for many years now.
Yeah.
What is the most popular song that you have right now, or the one that everybody, once they hear it, they're like, okay, that's
going
to be.
If I was to say, I'd say there's two that's separate. So if it's the youth, you know, if it's anyone coming up to me under like 18 years old, they're going to say still on Deen.
How can you say I ain't on Deen? Wagwan, my you, are you dumb? Been praying for about 5 years, and wallahi, I ain't missed one. But I'm still trying to skirt those demons. On the M1 BM speeding, altercations and situations. Had to give thanks to Allah, man's breathing. That night where I could've got wet, alhamdulillah, didn't pierce my neck. Bury my bro and tears got shed. Hearts got broken and eyes turned red. I can never sell my soul for a check. I don't take credit and I don't do debt. So I'm praying that I get that rahmah, cause I done things that I can't forget. How can you say I ain't on Deen? Every day ducking them shay our teens. I remember back when I lost my mind. You would've thought I was CeeLo Green. Sweat felt like Yo Mukiyama. That's why I'm in Senegal doing Ziyara. Man tried end me and then he got ended. Called out 48 laws of karma. Still on Deen. So I'm frontline there in the mosque. In the morning, pray for my nigga.
You know, it's a controversial song. It's very upbeat. It's like drill music, so I can understand why they enjoy that one.
Okay.
Maybe over that 80, maybe there will be it's either Ya Habibi.
Okay,
yeah. It'd be either Ya Habibi or the one that I just ended with the moon. Yeah, that'll probably be the most, alhamdulillah.
People in my city, they're searching for light. Ya Nabi, I will be making it bright now. Until the day I die. So I Shine.
Alhamdulillah.
I've been personally following you for a while. You know, we have a lot of great artists coming out of UK.
Alhamdulillah.
How's the scene over there in UK? And just as an artist, you know, the Muslim community, you know, there's different opinions about musical instruments. Yeah. How do you feel the
scene is out there?
Yeah.
I mean, I would love to say, it's thriving, but it's in a bit of dire situation right now because of the ultra conservatism, you know, and I'm someone that's always championing not necessarily that there's only, you know, that this opinion is correct, but to understand, because this is a fact, you know, and we can't run away from the fact that there is a difference of opinion on the matter,
right.
And this is not from myself, this is what the ulama of hundreds and hundreds of years have they've agreed on the fact that there is a difference of opinion,
right.
So if someone says, you know, this is not the way I want to express my, I say fine, I'm not going to try and convince you, but for you to say there's only one way and it's this way and there's no other way, that's what I've been pretty much battling for like the last 5 years. And the UK, I don't know what it is about the UK, because you might have it in America as well, but I notice it's, you know, UK is probably the and so I'm just out there fighting, but I'm like, me and a few others, like literally a handful in terms of that are doing the, but in terms of the vocals only scene, I think that's quite thriving at the moment, so I'll be honest. You know, you've got people like Saif Adam, Ilyas Mal, Ilyas Mal is from Canada, but he does a lot of the work in the UK. We've got Saeed from Canada as well, but they do a lot of stuff in the UK. I know you said UK, but every time I see them, they're always in the UK. And loads of other names, you know, that I apologize for not mentioning, but alhamdulillah. So it's the vocals only scene is doing well, and they're doing a lot of their own events, and they're putting it together. A lot of people are showing out, so, you know, alhamdulillah. That scene there is doing pretty
that's
well.
Good.
Yeah,
good.
Alhamdulillah.
Well, that's good. So what do you have down the line? You know, are you still writing? You got anything coming up?
Yeah, I'm a tortured artist. Ever since maybe like the beginning of, in the middle of 2023, I've kind of really trying to take a, you know, there's a book by Stephen Pressfield called Turning Pro, and it's about when you elevate your art just from something that you do whenever you feel like it, or as opposed to like, no, you become a professional, meaning you have regimented times where you do it and you put this out, as if, and treat it like a job, because that's what it is at the end of the day. I've been struggling with that my whole career. As I talked to you now, I've been still struggling with it. But alhamdulillah, I'm making steps in that direction of, making it more so I can release more consistently, move my ego out of the way, and just get it out, right? Because there's songs that are within me that is going to help someone that I've not even written yet, and they deserve to hear those songs, if it's going to help. You know, if there's any khair in it, then it's like almost an amana on me to get them out of myself, rather than, oh, I don't like how it sounds or this, and then I don't end up writing anything.
Right,
so it's like,
that's
what I'm battling with at the moment. So inshallah, keep your, you know, eyes on this
space.
Alhamdulillah.
We go through the same stuff.
Yeah,
we have three people. So
alhamdulillah, you got the support system.
But sometimes, you know, we got to agree.
I understand.
That's great. And so any words that you want to say to the, you know, the fans here, I guess in UK, but you got a lot of fans in the United States.
Yeah, alhamdulillah,
too.
Man. I mean, that's one thing I'm really going to try and do in 2024, is trying to make my presence in North America and Canada much more, because it's so big, and I feel like, I'm a lot more better received than in North America. I'm fighting every day in the UK. But alhamdulillah, you know, I love my people in the UK. But I also love, you know, the people out here in this side of the world as well.
Yeah.
So I'm going to make a much more concerted effort to try and do, you know, more, be out here more, work, collaborate with artists out here, and just make my presence more in 2024. So inshallah, you know, stay locked in. Inshallah.
Okay. Well, very good, man.
Barakallah fi. Alhamdulillah. So nice to meet
always
you.
Always good to meet you. This is
likewise.
My first time meeting the brother.
Yeah, alhamdulillah.
I've been, you know, a fan for a while. So.
Same, man. I've been following you for a long time. I remember Peace TV the first time it came on. I was like, yo, what's this, man? This is nice. It was the Subhanallah, la ilaha illallah. I was like, hey, man, this is nice. Alhamdulillah.
Keep it up, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, by the club, inshallah.
We'll see you in the United States.
Yes, inshallah, man. Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah.
This Dean TV video was made possible in part by Islamic Relief USA, working together for a better world, by Guidance Residential, Modern Finance, Timeless Values, and by Recycled Processes Incorporated.